गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। डॉक्टर रुचिका गुप्ता इज पोस्ट डॉक्टरल रिसर्च फेलो अंडर ISEA प्रोजेक्ट एट द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग, इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी गुवाहाटी, असम, एंड करेंटली वर्किंग इन द डोमेन ऑफ हार्डवेयर सिक्योरिटी। प्रायर टू दिस शी वॉज एसोसिएटेड with the Chandigarh University as associate professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering. After completing her PhD from National Institute of Technology, Surat, Gujarat, in the field of location privacy, she has more than 12 years of teaching experience, where she got a chance to reach out many students from various states of the country, including Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Gujarat and Punjab. She is gold medalist during her B.Tech from Kurukshetra University and a rank holder in M.Tech from Rajasthan Technical University, Kota. Her research interests include privacy preservation in location-based services, AI and machine learning, and secure network on chips design for the large multi-core systems. She has published many research papers in peer-reviewed journals and conference proceedings. She is a resource person to various security workshops, HTTP and FTPs. I welcome you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you, Dolly. Now I would like request to our today's speaker, Dr. Ruchika Gupta ma'am, to please take a charge and share your views about privacy preserving approaches for location based services. Welcome, ma'am. Welcome, Dr. Ruchika ma'am. Please,
thank you
over
so
to you, ma'am.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you so much, Manish, sir, for this wonderful introduction. Let me share the screen first and then I'll start because. Zoom, I don't know whether, okay. Is it visible to all the participants?
Yes, ma'am, it is visible, ma'am.
Okay. All right, so thank you once again for inviting me here. And all the participants, I talked to Dr. Manish to understand that who are my audience today? And he genuinely says that most of them are faculty members. Many of them are struggling to get their PhDs done. And many of them are actually pursuing it already from one institute or another. So when I talked with Manish sir, I realized that my talk should not be just like just giving the talk and then go away and you get the certificate, because these days online FDPs are very common, very rampant. Everybody's attending one or two. So my objective is all my audience today must get something from this FDP in terms of either the association with me or with my professors at IIT Guwahati through some research collaboration or getting know some new topic of the PhD or the research field where you can see the possibility of contribution. Because most of the time, what I have observed through my experience, many of us wants to do PhD, wants to get admission with some good institutes, want to enhance our academic skills, but we are unable to get the platform because of few reasons. Out of them, one reason is hame yahi nahi pata chalta ki hum which PhD topic we should go about. What we do, we just download few research papers, then read them, and then what we think, okay, just reading them, coming up, we know that what the research is and we will write the paper. And most of the time the papers are survey papers, right, where we try to publish it into the Blue Eye International publication houses, Scopus indexes houses. These kind of publications actually Any kind of publications are good if we know the some depth of the research. Otherwise, these papers, nobody is going to read it apart from you, and it is anyway going to see the dustbin. So my objective is, I am going to unfold one area of the research that very less people are aware about, but at the same time, it is very much relevant to our day-to-day life. Because everybody of us use a mobile phone, and there is one feature of the mobile phone that we do not give much concern about in the perspective I am going to put forward in front of you. So I want then many of you just look into it and try to see if is this a good ground of those who are already PhD holders, they may find it just addition to their knowledge base that, okay, there is one more area of the research in the security domain. And those who are not, and those who are want to do a PhD, maybe it may be helpful for them. So with this, I would like to come to my topic. So where are we right now? That always been an important question. Whenever you get out from your house, everybody would ask, where are you going? Your mother would ask, where are you going? Whenever you call someone, your friend, where are you? That means everybody wants to know where are you out of their natural instinct or out of their compulsive instinct that they wants to know where are you, so that accordingly they can make their judgment about you or they can know more about your life. But how we tell them that they where we are right now in the pandemic, we all are sitting, I can see many of you are sitting in your offices. Manish sir was in office, I am sitting in my house. But due to this pandemic, everybody was able to limit it to their houses. But earlier pandemic time and now after the pandemic time, gradually things are opening up. We are going to our offices and we go to other places as well. So in order to go there, what we need, we use our mobile phones. In which, suppose I am going to a new city, I want to know where is the nearest ATM. I am new to the city, I want to know where is the nearest ATM. What I would do, I will pick up my mobile phone, I will just go to the Google Maps, or I will go to the any GPS services, any route assistant services, Guala, Google Maps, My Places, Apple Assistance. There are a lot many assistances that will show you the nearest ATM, where you can go, what is your route destination, how you would reach from your current position to the position of ATM, how would you go? So we just say okay. The moment we say okay, our location coordinates gets from here to the server. For example, right now I take the example of Google server. Our location coordinates goes from here to server. That server would able to know your location coordinates in terms of longitude and latitude. These longitude and latitude will actually make your position currently identical to the physical plane. So your virtual identity that you have sent over the server through the communication medium and where you are right now on this earth will become exactly identical within an error margin of plus minus 3 feet. All right. And when we do that, in that time, if anybody's, what is that? The communication is whole aspect. Here we are giving the location coordinate and this is the entity that is providing the services. How this communication is being carried out, the communication can be secure, communication can be insecure. If the communication is insecure, then this is the possibility that if anybody can access the location coordinate of yours, then that person would know much more about you, right? So this is the context of keeping this research put forward, but at the same time, location-based services makes our life easy. So where are we right now? That has always been an important question. And these new set of services are making it even more relevant. It can save our time. We are going somewhere. You just need to know what is the route from this place to another place. Within just few friction of seconds, you will get that assistance. So that means it saves our time. Those days are gone when we go to the every chauraha and every nook and we just call somebody, hey, just tell me I need to go that place. What is the aim? How we should go there? And then we again reconfirm it by asking another person that we want to go to that place. How can we go? So now these days, such kind of incidences are very less now. People have their mobile phones in their hands. They just go through it and they just follow the path the GPS shows. So it basically makes the life of the user very easy. It saves our money. And at the same time, it saves our time. It saves our life. How it saves our life? It is possible that you are stuck in some elevator or you are stuck in some mall, and in that mall the fire erupts. If the fire is there, mall mein aag lag gayi hai, how would you go out? So some services, location based services, will sense your location and will send you the route you can use to get out from that mall. So these services are very intelligent services that can save our time, our money, or even our life. So these set of services are built on telecom operator network that takes the advantage of the fact that it needs to know who you are, and our location is the key. How would the network know who you are? How the server would know who you are? So the mobile handheld device, what we have, is actually our identity, and that is the location that makes other understand that this is who you are. So our location is the key. Okay, just think about the network of the devices that moves around. Those days are gone when you need to go to the sit of the particular office, desktop machine is given, LAN cable is connected, then only you come on the workstation and you can do your work. These days, people, what they do, they sit in the cafe coffee day, they sit in the Starbucks coffee, they just plug in and that's it. When they connect to the Wi-Fi, that means they have their virtual identity, but how would the service provider would know who you are, what you are doing, right? What kind of data you are asking for? They just need to know who you are. And in that case, our location is the key. So location-based services making such kind of communication of the network devices that are moving around very easy. So knowing answers is location-based services is knowing on such answers that what these devices are doing, what kind of data they are operating up. And so it added to the value services to the customers. The popularity of the mobile phone. When it got GPS, this is a complete bought home, the location-based services values to the consumer. These days, you hardly see an app that doesn't use location information. Have you ever observed that whenever you get that information, whenever you download an app, many of the apps ask for your location value, location information because they want to give some customized user experience so that it makes the user's life easy. For example, have you seen many of the games application, whenever you download and ask for your location, then they get to know in which part of the world you are in, not just country, in which part of the world you are in. And according to that, they can send you few customized backgrounds. For example, Diwali is celebrated only in our country. So they will give you the customized background in the games, Christmas background in the game. So that makes the life of the user easier. So location-based services is actually very powerful technology that makes the client's life very easy and very smart. So as per the connotation, location-based services needs user's exact location coordinate in order to supply the exact services to the user. It grants access to relevant, up-to-date information about their surroundings, and it also allows business to provide current updates to their clients. How actually the location is sent in the in class, I guess, seventh standard of the school, there was the there used to be the chapter of Earth. In that chapter, it is narrated that Earth is actually some virtual lines are covering the Earth, some horizontal and vertical lines. The horizontal lines is responsible for longitude, and vertical lines are used for latitude, and where they actually meet, that point actually decides where we are. And each we have 119 lines, and each line having the distance between each line is, I guess, the 100 meters. And that is the way the complete Earth is divided into the horizontal and vertical lines. That is a way we able to know where we are on this Earth. So that is why this is the advancement of the technology. And the how do we know with exactly where here we are? This is our horizontal and vertical line combinations. These lines are actually sensed by the global positioning system GPS. With the help of 3 satellites, we able to know where we are exactly. So these satellites, these GPS satellites actually let the server know that this mobile device is, which is sending the signal at such and such time, is standing or is it there in this place. So we need, how many satellites do we need? We need a minimum of 3 satellites so that server would know where we are exactly on the globe.
Hello. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. There was some problem, but now it's okay.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, sir. Please continue.
Okay. All right. So there are 3 kind of location-based services. First is pull-based LBS, push-based, and tracking LBS. Pull-based services, most of the time, are those services where we do not use the GPS all the time on. We keep the GPS in an on and off manner. I want to know if I am going right now at outside at my house and I don't know the place, the route where I want to go, what I would do? I would go to the Google Maps. I'll try to find out the route assistance, but at the same time, I will not keep my GPS on all the time. So pull LBS, as the name suggests, we are pulling the information from the server whenever it is needed. So whenever it is needed by the client, it will keep the GPS on. Then it will allow the server to sense its location. And after that, it pulls the information that was required by the client. It can be nearest Pizza Hut, it can be nearest petrol pump station, it can be nearest ATM, or any type of query it asks that is relevant to the user's location. Another is the push LBS. As the name suggests, push. Already server is pushing some information into the user mobile. For example, suppose I am a very good member of the Starbucks coffee, or for example, Cafe Coffee Day. The moment I am walking and there is a Cafe Coffee Day, it will actually, the moment it senses my presence there, the server automatically will send me the promotional offer that Cafe Coffee Day is just 50 meters away from you. And today it is giving you 30% discount on so and so coffee. Please come and let us give you a chance to serve you a hot coffee with minimum prices. So such kind of promotional events are some events that we are not looking forward to, but while we are into that vicinity where we are going, automatically server senses your location and it sends you certain promotional offers. Such kind of services are known as push LBS, where GPS is considered while your location is considered to be on most of the time throughout, so that any other services and servers can sense your location and can give you the information, relevant information accordingly. Another is known as tracking LBS. Tracking LBS is that kind of LBS that is used to most of the time track the commodity. Suppose mera transfer hua hai, earlier we used to live in Bombay and now we are here in Chandigarh. When we came here, there was we came four days prior to when our all, you know, furniture and our whole stuff came from transferred from there to there. I want to monitor at exactly at that time that where my stuff is going, where my commodities are moving from Mumbai to here. So such kind of LBS where the continuous monitoring is needed, that means all the time the location is being sensed by the server and it is very much well aware about the each and every movement of the user or commodity, or it can be anything like fleet management. Such kind of thing the tracking LBS is used. So what kind of services we seek such with this location-based services? It can be your nearest petrol pump. It can be nearest eatery destination, McDonald's, pizza. It can be the ATM near you. It can be the cinema you want to go. You are in some different place and you want to go and see a movie. What you would do, you would use location-based service. It can be used to find the weather. What is the you are visiting a new place and you want to know what is the weather today, or what going to be the weather of that day on certain date. Or you don't want to save your time from wasteful driving. I want to optimize my time and I do not want to waste my time in some, you know, senseless driving where I am stuck into the jam and just waste killing my time. So proactively I may plan my visit accordingly by using the route assistances. Or it can be used for fleet assistant, as I have told you. I am sending something. I am a businessman. I am a businesswoman. I want to send something. Then I want to monitor where my data, where my, you know, my stuff is going. Another is the emergency services like exit route. In this case, it is possible you are in the mall, you are shopping. All of the sudden, aapko pata chala ki bahut na, matlab, there is a smoke outside. Right, you go outside, there's a fire. You don't know anything about that mall, how to get out of that mall, because mall is a very big infrastructure. You don't know all the exit points, all the entry points. There are 100 number of the gates, you don't know. So the moment we put the LBS on, it will automatically send you the evacuation route. So you just take that route and you can save your life as well. So LBS makes the life of the user very, very easy. So these are the major application areas of LBS. Emergency services, I have already discussed. Information services, routing assistance, news, weather information, tracking services, and entertainment. Entertainment, I have not discussed in detail. Entertainment can be that you are going to a new place or new country, right? In new country, suppose I am visiting Frankfurt in Germany. I don't know who all my ex-friends, all my ex-colleagues are there or not. I would just like to meet them. So I keep my location services on and I try to locate my friend who are either in my social networking site or their contacts are there in me, or possibly my ex-colleague is also visiting the same city during that duration. which I am not aware about. So we can go for locating a friend. People go for dating, right? Those who are interested. And you can also play the online games. So such kind of application areas. And if we see, if we take a pause and see, then you will find everybody of us use these services in one way or other. So LBS has already become an indispensable feature of our lives. So now the question comes at how this LBS operates. What are the different basic building block for this smart technology to come into the reality? So first is mobile device, the central architecture, central component of this framework, where everything is revolves around mobile device. Whatever I do, I need this. The moment I lose this, I cannot use the services. Another is service provider, definitely, who is doing, I am the one who wants the services. Service provider is the one who is going to give me the services, right? So these two are obviously the, anybody can think of. Another is how can we carry out this communication from here to this point? This is me, this is a server. This is known as communication network. And ultimately, we also need positioning technologies that lets this server know where I am. So composition technology actually provides my device's longitude and latitude, or we can say X and Y location, and that sends to location-based service provider. So communication networks plays an spine. It plays like a spine for overall communication. Overall, this LBS, location-based services, communication network is the spine of this technology. And then LBS provider is a server, but server cannot have everything with itself, right? So this server obviously needs some data and content provider, right? That can see where, what the information is, what kind of information a user seek, and provide result back to the user. So these are the LBS component, and the story which I tells you is depicting in this diagram, where the mobile client sends the query request, base station with the using of this base station forwards a query to the concerned server, right? Which server is more closer to it, which is more relevant. So it forwards a query according to that to the location-based server. Location-based server is actually checking the result from the data, assisted databases, providing back the requested result. And finally, the query response is given back to the mobile client. So this is the story that we have talked. It's very, very powerful technology that provides the right information to right target audience at right place and at right time. So another is the aspect of location privacy. This is how location-based services making our life easy. Now, what are the privacy concern into it? Suppose I am working in an office. Would I ever want that my colleagues would know that I have gone through an HIV testing center last week? Do I ever want it? I would never want, because I may have my insurance. I would never want my colleagues would start thinking a different about me, because in India such kind of statements or such kind of information put some wrong notions in people's mind because of one thing or other. So I do not want to destroy my image, what people have in their mind. So I would never want, but we cannot deny the fact that location, I am going to the location-based server and I am finding where is the nearest HIV. And that day I was there in that clinic. We cannot deny the fact that ultimately the locations are being sent. What if my location gets disclosed somewhere? What if server have some malicious intent? What if somebody actually trying to see where I am? So what kind of attacks can be, suppose it can be active or it can be passive attack. Somebody is just sitting and sniffing that you went to HIV AIDS center and you are getting yourself tested. I would never want to reveal this in front of anybody. So doctor visit, I would never want to reveal, because a single doctor visit tells some different story. But after few months, if you are going to the baby, baby feeding shop, it will tell altogether a different story. We all are faculty members here, right? We have in the morning hours, during our working hours, we have our professional life. But once we are done, if we are going back our home, then it is our personal life. We might go to the pubs. We might go to have some drinks with our friends. We can go to the discos. We can go wherever we want, right? So at the same time, I do not want anybody to know what I do in my private leisure time. So privacy comes a big concern here. Another is, if anybody would know that every Tuesday I go to temple, or every Sunday I go to church. If somebody is sniffing my location for a certain amount of time, it is a passive listening. Only it's sniffing my location that on Tuesday I was there, another Tuesday I was again there, another Tuesday I'm there. Or another person who is going to church every Sunday, then the person who is sniffing our location would able to know easily that I am a Hindu or I am a Christian. That means what are my religious inclinations will definitely be disclosed just by observing my locations without even having any active attack. Just people are, somebody who is the attacker is sniffing my location and would able to know that I am a Hindu, or I go to the temple, or in the evening I go to that pub. So such kind of disclosures I do not want to do. And at the same time, I want to use the location-based services is the biggest research problem that have been targeted in the literature so far. So the same way I am just buying a flower for my friend, I'm going to a pub, I do not want to reveal it that I went and buy the flowers. So this is the very important privacy concerns, and security is another, the privacy is one of the tributary of the security. It is one of the aspect, very important aspect of security. And I will also like to mention one thing. In 2017, Mark Zuckerberg, the owner of Facebook and WhatsApp, he was asked to produce in front of the US Congress in US. And I don't know whether how many of you watched that video in which he was asked that whether you have the information about the users, about your Facebook users, some private information, do you have the access on it? Do you have the right to see on it? And I don't know whether you have remembered on it or not, but this video went viral, and that time even it was questioned that even Facebook is accessing our privacy. And the ex-CEO of Google, the Eric Schmidt, he also said that if you want to keep anything very private, then do not keep on the internet at all. But this LBS is actually building around that. You get this, you want the services, you let us know who you are. If you are not letting us know, you are unable to get the services. I am in a seminar. Can I call you later? Okay. So in this case, location-based services specifically on the Facebook, if I am concerned about the privacy, I might not put my real name. I might not put my real my real address, my real phone number, or even my real photograph, right? Still, I can able to access the services from the Facebook. But location-based service is unlike Facebook, because here, if you are giving wrong location, you are not able to take the right quality of service. You are sitting in this Chandigarh, and you are asking for ATM in, for example, Bhopal. It is of no use of mine. So here the privacy is big concern, because the data what you are sending, the moment we tweak that data, your quality of services will be very low. So that's why it is very challenging topic, that how can we get the quality of services in location-based services while preserving the location privacy of the user. I hope the research problem must be very clear to you, those who are listening to me. Those who are listening to me, can you just type one in your chat box? I want to know that how many of you are very much clear about the research problem that I have just narrated. Type one in the chat box. Okay. Okay, three of the replies I received. 4, 5, 6. Seven. Eight. Okay. So research problem is clear to you. Okay. Very nice. Thank you. At least I get 10 of the replies. You are very much here. So this is dealt in the literature at a certain stretch. So we cannot deny the fact that industries are looking into where you are going, right? You are going into the mall. Such kind of privacy breaches are more into the Western countries because their life is very much easy. They do not even worry to that whether I am keeping my GPS on or off, because they think that every responsibility is the government to protect them. However, in India, such kind of self-awareness is much more in the public, apart in comparison to those who are outside in the Western world, the developed nation, because they actually very much easygoing kind of attitude. So what they do, they keep their location on and they get into the mall. The moment they get into the mall, all the stores in the mall, they sense that you are into their vicinity. They suppose my favorite brand is Biba, or my favorite brand is suppose Lifestyle. The moment I enter into that mall, Lifestyle will send me the message automatically, just by sensing my location. Ki ma'am, we are going to give you 20% discount or 30% discount because it's your birthday, or you are a special customer. Today, we are going to give you 30% on women's apparel or for kids discount. Whatever it comes, then you will go. So such kind of when automatically your geolocation is being sensed, and then your vicinity is providing you with such kind of offers, it is known as the concept of geotagging. Geotagging. And industry also look into where you are so that it can give you more. And then it may increase their revenue, the business revenues as well. So it is very much alarming that if somebody knows you are where you are, then somebody can know where you are not. If somebody is sensing that you are in the mall, that means you are not at your home, and your home can be at stake. If somebody knows that you are into the National Highway 8, and that means you are not at home. So that means your presence can be, your life can be fatal. It can be threatened. In the literature, location privacy protection solutions are discussed at stretch. Most of the solutions are based on the first architecture, and that is known as centralized architecture. Centralized architecture says that if I am the user and you are the service provider, then a third guy would be sitting in between who will keep my identity safe. It will protect my identity, will communicate to LBS, LBS will communicate back to that, and then it will connect to me again. Only this third person, that is known as the anonymizer, knows who actually the real me. So that is known as centralized architecture, where a third party sits in between the anonymous user and location-based service provider and helps to make the user identity and user location anonymous to others. This is like somebody borrowed some money from me, right? Or he wants to borrow some money from me. I don't rely on him. What I would do, I would put my third friend into it, right? Okay, now you are responsible. He must know that I have given you money. I will give my money to him and he will give that money to the other guy, so that in this communication, the third party is witnessing the communication that has been taken place between the user and the location-based service provider. But what is the downside of it? This approach is actually not very, it is very much popular and well accepted till the time the number of queries or number of users that is connected to the location-based servers were lesser in number. Jab zyada users anonymizer pe jaane lage, because anonymizer is also a kind of machine, it's also a kind of server. So anonymizer was become the bottleneck, right? So that means we need more, so computing power all depends on anonymizer. What if anonymizer gets down? Suppose anonymizer fails, the whole system comes down. So single point of failure is there in anonymizer, right? The single point of failure. Second thing, it can be the bottleneck for the entire system. It unable to handle, suppose 4,000 requests come just in one go. It will not able to handle it, because it is not designed such way. It is just able to handle only 400 requests, for example. So the overall performance of this system depends on only one entity, that is anonymizer. So that is the downside of it. Another is all the information, all the information is present in the anonymizer, because anonymizer knows everything about the user, the correct location, correct identity. What if anonymizer gets malicious? Right? The moment the anonymizer gets malicious, everything is compromised. So such kind of what we have, the centralized architecture downside in the network, computer network, the same centralized architecture downsides also present in this type of approaches. So in this approach, what happens? Anonymous user sends the location to the anonymizer. Anonymizer tweak it by one algorithm or other. Many people have incorporated and presented many of the algorithm that it will add noise to it. Some people say it's a differential privacy. There are many ways to tweak the real location X and Y coordinate. Anonymizer will tweak it. Or one another is most important aspect is it will know what is the right thing, what is the real user, and it will send to the LBS. LBS doesn't know anything about it. LBS give result back to the anonymizer, and anonymizer filters out the wrong results and give right result to the right user. So that is the way the anonymized centralized architecture approaches operates. Another is, because of the downside of centralized approaches, many authors and researchers have shifted their focus for anonymizer from centralized to decentralized architecture. These architectures do not consider or do not involve any third party at all. Wo kehte hain ki hame direct LBS provider se baat karni hai, then why to keep anybody, you know, there for help? No, we do not want to rely on any trusting third party. Instead, we will trust to somebody who are like me. For example, A is the original user here, and A wants to communicate to LBS provider. What A would do? A would make the ad hoc group, right? It will make a group by calling their friends, right? B, C, D, and E are some of the user that is going to help original user A. In this case, A selectively choose one of the user, like in this example D, as a random agent, and then the overall communication will take place through D. So LBS provider would not know whether the data has come from D or from A. So this is a beauty of this architecture where no third party is involved, but still user can able to have the services it asked for. What is the downside of it? Downside of this architecture can be anybody from the group. What can be the downside of this architecture? I'll give you 1 minute if anybody can reply. What is the demerit? Okay, nobody is answering, so let me tell you. The demerit can be, in India, we have population, too much population, right? So getting other people like me, for example, here A is the original user, B, C, D, and E are all the other users. So getting more mobile user within the same area is much easier in the populated countries like India and China. But if we go to the desert places or we go to the places where the population is very less, while their demography, while their geographical regions are very much big. Big area countries with a less population, it will become very difficult to find even 5 or 10 users in my area who are willing to be the part of this group. So in this case, the location-based services might get delayed because we are unable to get the right number of users. Or it is possible that those who have come into that area is not willing to help me. So such kind of downside is also available in decentralized architecture. So this is the comparison, what I have just said. These are the comparison of these two approaches. What are the advantages and shortcomings? We have already discussed this by and large. So on basis of these two, I could able to find few defense architecture, the trusted third party based and trusted third party free architecture. Trusted third-party based architecture is anonymizer-based, and trusted third-party free architecture is distributed architecture where no trusted third-party is involved. So in the literature, if you see, this tree is not balanced. If you see, the left arm of the tree is exploited too much than right arm of the tree. Because in the beginning of the LBS, when less people used to have the GPS facilities and they were free to use it, that time it was sufficient to have a trusted third party based architecture. But later on, when there was more security and privacy breaches and single point of failure, then people have shifted from trusted third party to trusted third party free. So here, if you see, the right arm of the tree is less explored, and it is very fertile land of research where you can come up with some privacy solution that can find a adequate balance between the location, what you are sending, and the quality of service that is being provided by having either trusted third party based or free approaches. So this is very fertile land of research. Those who think that this area is really very interesting. In this, I would like to tell about, I have suggested three or four approaches. As my time allows, I will discuss that how many approaches I can discuss with you. If anybody feels that I am going too slow, then please write in the chat box. I will try to pace it up. Or those who think I am going to write any your concern, please write it so that I can make my presentation more effective. So one of the major concept is K-anonymity, that is discussed in privacy preservation in big data, in location-based privacy, in wherever you would listen the concept of privacy, there this K-anonymity principle will definitely be exploited. ये जो principle था that was given by L. Sweeney in 2002. Yes, key anonymity principle is 2002. What this principle says? This principle says that if here I am, right, this is my location, I am the person, I want to be anonymous. Anonymous ka jo dictionary meaning hai, wo hota hai, the one, if you are not able to identify by any other entity, that means you are anonymous. Right? Anonymous means I am there, but nobody knows who I am in terms of my location, my user, my physical. So anonymity is derived from the very basic word from the English, that is being anonymous, and being anonymous is to hiding your identity. That from there, this word is picked up. K anonymity, as a name suggests, I want to be hide, or I want to be not distinguishable among K users, right? Suppose I want to be 5 anonymous. That means the probability of knowing me should be 1/5. If I want to be 20 anonymous, then my probability should be 1/20. What does that mean? Suppose here I am standing, this is my location, and this is the minimum area where I want to be anonymized. Jahan pe main chupna chahti hun, right? Anonymous, jahan pe mujhe chupna hai. I want to hide my real identity. This is the area. I want to be 5 anonymous. 5 anonymous means meri jo probability hai to identify me should be 1/5. Right? So here it is 5 anonymous means out of the 5 locations, one location would be mine and rest 4 locations would be different. It can be dummy locations or this can be real mobile users location, but that will make me 1/5 distinguishable. So that is the concept of K-anonymity that says that location-based server would not able to know your identity with not more than the probability of 1/k, where k is the number of users in that minimum area, a min. This is the concept of K-anonymity. What is the downside and upside of it? What is the value of K? This is again very fertile land of research, very interesting and challenging topic. What will be the value of K? क्या हम ये बोल सकते हैं कि if I am 20 anonymous, then my privacy is preserved. But if I am 19 anonymous, then my privacy is breached. Can we say that with a conviction? कि भाई ऐसा can we just float such kind of arguments? No, we cannot. So it is again a very debatable topic that what is the value of K? If I give the value K is equal to 100 in Chandigarh, suppose I go to the market, even in this pandemic, everybody is in the, you know, markets. Everybody is going and shopping and doing everything. If I am going to give, I want to be 50 anonymous. It will not be difficult for me to find 49 real users. But if you are going to some deserted place where if you are here, then another person would be kilometers far away. Then it will not possible even to fulfill 10 value. K is equal to 10 anonymous. So that is depends upon where you are, what is your geographical regions, and how much value of K gives you the satisfaction of being private in terms of knowing, exposing yourself to the server. So this is about the concept of K-anonymity that has been talked at a very larger stretch in the research. Bahut jagah milega research papers mein. So I am going to give you today, I am going to discuss 2 solutions. Out of them, one solution says trusted third party based architecture. That is name is VicPro, the vicinity protection. I will tell you how did I come up to it and how we worked on it. So in this, we have explored the principle of K-anonymity, and another very popular terminology in privacy researches is quasi-identifier. Bahut sare log bolte hain quasi-identifier. It is quasi-identifier. Try to call it that way. So quasi-identifiers are those identifiers, jo bhi information you make public and thinking nothing will happen. For example, aapka LinkedIn account hai. LinkedIn account पे आपके कुछ information. Okay, just forget about LinkedIn account because most of the time we put the right thing there. Okay, suppose you keep something on Facebook, you keep something on Instagram, you keep something on Pinterest, right? You are keeping different thing at different 3 or 4 location, but a fourth guy, a different guy who actually have the access to all of these information can link all these together, right? They, if you link all of your social platform information, it is possible that linking all your scattered information into one, your personal identity would able to reveal more in front of them. So such kind of data that is present there, but that is not linked. But if we link them, it will breach your privacy. It is known as quasi-identifier. So quasi-identifiers are those data that is already present into the digital world, and linking them to one another will actually give a takeaway of your privacy, one or small part of your privacy. So that is what is used in this scenario. Here what we think. Okay, here what we think, the first mobile is vicinity A. अभी तक हम पढ़ते आ रहे थे K anonymity की, जो जितने भी हमारे पास, suppose K की value मेरे पास 4 है, तो मुझे 3 और user dummy या फिर real location की user भेजना है, जिससे कि location based server के पास 4 user की value पहुंचेगी. जब उसके पास 4 पहुंचेगी तो उसे ये नहीं पता चलेगा कि उन 4 में से मैं कौन सी वाली हूँ, right? Actual में तो मैंने भेजी थी वो query. So it will find result for all 4 of them and will give that 4 result back to the trusted third party. That trusted third party knows very intelligent. It will filters out the wrong results because वो तो सब added थे in order to fulfill the K anonymity. Right result को वो भेज देगा मेरे पास और the right user. So that is a simple case. But मेरा what when we were studying it, we could able to identify there is a gap. What was the gap? If I am sitting in NRI Institute of Engineering, in NRI Institute of Research, Bhopal, then if I send a query, then all of the value of K minus one more users will be added from NRI Institute of Technology. Right? If you are sitting there and Manish sir sends an information, location information, trying to find out where is the nearest Pizza Hut. He is having his birthday today, for example. He wants to give party to everybody, right? But he is new to the place. He wants to know where I need to go. What he would do, he would contact to the location-based server, sending his location coordinate, but he wants to be anonymous. 7 anonymous means 6 more faculty members, staff members, anybody who is around him. And A mean value, the suppose 100 meters. A mean value is 100 meters. That means in the while he is into the center, the 100 by 100 square, all these 6 more users will be needed. And then all that bunch of the location coordinates will be sent to the location-based service provider. And all this is done by the third party. So when we do that, in that case, ultimately the query will be originated from NRI Institute of Technology. Location-based server would not know that out of these 7 who sent this query, but location-based server would know that this query has been originated by NRI Institute of Research. So in this, what has been discussed in the literature earlier, we could able to identify that however the user information or privacy has not breached, but at the same time, vicinity location, vicinity information is somehow compromised. Huh? It is very simple thing. And let me tell you, such kind of wisdom, such kind of thought that how to find the research gap, it has not come just from you sitting and, you know, sleeping and, getting over in the morning and in the dream, you would say this is the research gap. No, it will come into the dream only when if you have the habit of reading. So the thumb rule for finding the research gap is reading. Just make yourself very clear that I need to read 2 paper before I go to sleep, right? Or either, whenever you scroll down before sleeping or getting up, just scrolling down, you must make sure before end of the day you are going to read these three papers. But many of us don't even know how to read the paper. See, if by I get time, I'll let you know how to read the paper as well. Okay. So this, I am moving this cursor. I don't know whether you can see the cursor movement. I think now you can see. ये तो highlighter है. Arrow. No, it's not working. Pointer thai. ओके सो दिस इफ यू सी अभी तक हमारे पास जो के एनोनिमिटी थी दैट वाज एप्लीकेबल टू ओनली सिंगल विसिनिटी आफ्टर आइडेंटिफाइंग दिस रिसर्च गैप व्हाट वी सेड वी विल यूज दिस के एनोनिमिटी प्रिंसिपल बस इंस्टेड ऑफ वन लोकेशन वी विल टेक द रेस्ट ऑफ द के माइनस क्लाइंट फ्रॉम अदर ज्योग्राफिकली डिफरेंट लोकेशन सो दैट 1 by k would be the probability of finding the user and 1 by n would be the probability of finding the vicinity if we are considering that n vicinities are there in all. So that was a simple rule here. So I have tried to picturize it that V11 is where we are sitting. So what we are doing, if I want to be 20 anonymous, then 20, 25 anonymous, then 5 clients would be here, 5 from V5, 5 from V7, 5 from V15, and 5 for V17. So overall value of K would be 25. However, the vicinity would be more than 1. That means 5 vicinity. So the probability of identifying the user would be 1 by 5 into 1 by 25. Otherwise, earlier it was only 1 by 25. So that is the beauty of this this concept where we could able to strengthen the privacy of the user. Some of the people from here, this is the original. Some people added from other vicinity, some from this and some from this. So that is how I could able to achieve it. So what is a proposed idea? To focus on user vicinity, that is obfuscated. Obfuscated dictionary meaning is to hide. With a set of geometrical transformation, कैसे पता चलेगा? So here I am the original. I used to be very good in computer graphics, and there I have had the phenomenon of transformation, right? The transformation, a geometrical transformation, where we have translation, where some amount of delta x and delta y is added to the coordinates. We had concept of reflection. Using this, a basic concept of transformation, I could able to achieve this strengthening of privacy. So original user is coming from here. So first humne iski base station se wo nikali length reflect kar diya to we get this coordinate, this region. Another region is translated, heterogeneous translation, not homogeneous. This is another. So we could able to get 4 different vicinities. Out of them, one is real and rest of the 3 are just to make just to fool the location based server. So this was the concept. And these are the experimental result I was doing in Sardar Vallabhbhai National Institute of Technology. So this is the way from where the query was originated. This is the concept where I could able to find the different values to fulfill the concept of K anonymity. Here, if you see, where while I was doing it, I could able to understand the limitation of my approach. Approach was, can you see here one Tapi river is flowing? Huh? What happened if all of these coordinates lies into this, in Tapi river? Right? The chances of getting the 10 values in the river is very narrow, and location-based server would able to know this is just to fool me. So the chances of filtering out the wrong data would be much higher at location-based server side. So this was the small limitation of my work, that what if after the geometrical transformation, the area that it falls into becomes marshy area or some area where there is no human movement, then the privacy will not be that strengthened up. And this concept what I have given is later taken care by one of my junior colleague who is working on that, how can we now make it more strengthened if the data lies into such kind of areas where human movement is almost equivalent to nil. So this is the experimental result we could able to find out. Interval and Casper cloaking are the very benchmark cloaking. IV could able to compare our results with this. And this is the, if we can see that our proposed approach marginally works good, but if we see the strengthening the privacy, it is much larger than existing one, because it is not only working on strengthening the privacy of the user, also with the respect of with respect to strengthening the privacy of vicinity. And if vicinity is protected, then user privacy is, by the dominoes effect, cascading effect, it automatically gets enhanced. So we call it vicinity protection. So that's why I have taken the syllables VIC Pro. We call it the VIC Pro. So this is the experimental results, where you can see the small rectangle triangle. This triangle is the original user, and rest of them are the users used to fulfill the concept of K anonymity. Here we have used the value 40. That means 1 would be the real and 39 would be the users to fulfill K anonymity. We have experimented it using K is equal to 80. And another is, I don't know whether, okay. And we have also experimented it for K is equal to 100 as well, and K is equal to 120. I could not able to get the result here, but we could be able to test it for more than 4 or 5 different values of K anonymity. And one more thing, center of ASR attack. This center of ASR attack means, ASR means A mean value, anonymous spatial region. Anonymous means being hidden, special matlab related to the space, spatial. And region means the area. So anonymous spatial region means, agar hum log keval ek vicinity use karte, dekhiye, agar you just consider these vicinities are not being added here, only single vicinity is there. So agar aap inka average lenge na, if you try to find out that centroid of this area, it will definitely come out closer to the triangle. Definitely, by the virtue of mathematics. This centralized, if we take only single region, then centroid will be highly likely be the real user. So this is the center of ASR attack. Anybody who location-based server, if it is malicious, it could able to find out the centroid, the center part, center coordinate, that which is the closer to that center coordinate is very highly likely to be the real user. So this approach could able to break that concept of mathematical correctness. And here we can see center of ASR attack says that it should be here, the dark solid black circle, but actually the real location was here. So it could able to protect it against center of ASR attack. I hope this is very much clear, very easy concept, and at the same time, very easy and okay. At the same time, it is very easy. Oops. Yeah, and very informative, very easy. Now I would like to say one thing, that many of you are thinking that how we come up with this. Let me tell you, all of the researches that is being going on, they are just exploiting the already existing phenomena. Already existing phenomena, geometrical transformation already existed since ages. Many people use, for example, we have the concept of palindrome. Kis kis ne sabne aapne palindrome ka to padha hoga na, palindrome. How many of you knew that palindrome program we just make our student to make? They write a program in C to see whether the string is palindrome or not. Please type 1 in the chat box, those who are really connected with me. I'm more like a radio jockey, where I can see that how many listeners are tuned to me, but I am unable to interact with them. I feel like a radio jockey today. Manish sir, only you are listening. Anybody who's listening to me, this is going to be very informative what I am going to tell you. Thank you, sir. How many of you give your students the program of palindrome in any language? Okay, just forget about C. any language to identify whether the string is palindrome or not. Okay, और आपको आपने करा होगा अपने टाइम में. What is the okay? Nobody is replying to me. All right, let me. Have you ever observed that what is the purpose of keeping it? Palindrome is a, okay. Now, those who are listening to me, आप मुझे बता सकते हो कि ऐसी कौन सी real life problem है that can be solved using palindrome? कोई भी एक रियल लाइफ प्रॉब्लम जिसको हम पैलिंड्रोम का कोड यूज करके वी कैन सॉल्व. वेयर पैलिंड्रोम कोड कैन बी यूटिलाइज्ड. आई एम गिविंग यू द वन मिनट टाइम. प्लीज टेल मी एनी जस्ट थिंक ऑफ. प्लीज डू नॉट गूगल इट. राइट, ट्राई नॉट टू गूगल इट. आई नो मैनी ऑफ यू आर गेटिंग टू योर कीबोर्ड्स एंड ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट वेयर इज द पैलिंड्रोम कैन बी यूज्ड. आई जस्ट वॉन्ट यू टू. आई विल गिव यू द आंसर एनी वे. What can be the areas where palindrome is used to solve any problem? Answering question is more important than answering the question right. Even if it is wrong, the answering and participating into, I will tell you, if I get a chance, I will tell you my story, how my answering question and how my communication, you know, helped me getting into the IIT. It may sound a little different to you or ki nahi nahi aisa nahi hota. I tell you from my story, I was never imagined that I can go to the IIT Guwahati for having my postdoc, but because of me getting into the communication, I could be the part of it. Anyway, so let me tell you, nobody's answering as of now. Palindrome, normally whenever we have these small code construct, right, either it is matrix multiplication. It is so talked about phenomena of matrix multiplication. People are still solving it. That can we reduce the time of the complexity, or the can we more optimize it? Can we make it even more faster? Matrix multiplication. But if we see around, where the hell matrix multiplication is using, right? Where we are using it? Please pardon my tongue. It is just an expression. Where we are using it? Or example. Where are those problems that is solved by palindrome? Why we are asking our kids, or why we were asked to solve palindrome problem? So in reality, palindrome, have you heard about the DNA sequences, ATCG, genome sequencing, bioinformatics, where they try to find out some patterns in your DNA? Adenine, thymine, guanine, cytosine. We are made up of DNA. There's a double helical structure, something like that. We must have heard. Everybody of us read it during our school days. So for DNA sequences, we must need to know where it is. If we read from right to left and read and left to right, is it making some pattern? If they are palindrome, then they mimic some different structure. If they are not palindrome, then they mimic some different structure of DNA. So the palindrome code that we studied in the first year of computers engineering, that is being utilized to solve the real life problem here. So whenever you read something in terms of some technique, for example, I have used this geometrical transformation here. All the time, the researchers are using the basic concept. They are just trying to utilize it to solve some bigger real life problem. So my advice to you, everybody has a sweet tooth. Sweet tooth means hame ek na subject le hi lungi. Some people like data structure, some people like database management system, some like OS, computer organization and architecture. Some are very, you know, sweet tooth. We always like to take such kind of wo wala subject hame lena hai, and we almost have a fight in our department ki ye subject mujhe kyun nahi mila. whenever you take that subject this time, try to understand, can we use these concepts in the research problem you are struggling with or you want to target? The moment you get this, whenever you read something, try to understand why we are reading graphs. Iska use kya hai? Why the hell I need to learn all this, you know, this memory goes this, here, what is this Bellardi's anomaly, why this FCFS, I mean, karna kyun hai? The moment you have this inquisition in your mind will gradually be tuned into that mode where you would know that how to use this phenomena or this technique in order to solve some bigger problem. आप कभी भी देखना, जब भी डिस्टेंस हमें निकालना होता है, वी ऑलवेज गो फॉर इक्लूडियन डिस्टेंस. ऑलवेज इक्लूडियन डिस्टेंस इज अ यू नो वेल एस्टैब्लिश्ड फिनोमेना. वेर एवर यू फाउंड टू नीड टू फाइंड द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू पॉइंट्स ए एंड बी, यू नीड इक्लूडियन डिस्टेंस. सो सच काइंड ऑफ थिंग. सो यू कैन यूज इक्लूडियन डिस्टेंस इन टू योर रिसर्च. You can use it. You just need to refer this Euclidean. Just give it a note that I am citing your work. That's it. So if using those small constructs, you are solving some real life problem, that's all the research is all about. So my submission is, my discussion point is, try to understand, to find the usefulness of each technique you study in your theory or you use in your practical, and your problem of research will definitely be very reduced because then you know how to use the concept into the practical form to solve some bigger problem. Anyway, enough of the guidelines for research. I don't know it is how much it is going to helpful for you. So another is, when we I would like to add one more this. So another defense architecture, because of the drawback of first architecture that we have suggested, VicPro, it was trusted third party based architecture, and the very downside of trusted third party based is, why to trust a third party at all? Why to trust? So trusting a third party in itself is a graver assumption, is a very bad assumption in itself. So then we come up with another solution that is known as trusted third party free. No trusted third party is here. No. कहाँ use होता है ये caching with trust? अच्छा, suppose अगर मैं आज यहाँ पे lecture नहीं ले रही होती तो मैं आपके department में होती, right? NIER, हम कहीं auditorium होता या आपके seminar होता, where either we will be discussing like this, the you know just as the table is formed here, or it would be like many, you know, one to many kind of relationship where I would be standing on the podium and you are sitting right there in front of me and listening to me. So we will be there, all of there physically, right? So suppose a conference is going on, main aapke office mein hoon, and I want to download the proceeding of that conference. Huh? So main location based server pe jaakar download nahi karna chahti. Main nahi batana chahti because I want to keep my location information private. What I would do, I will try to make an ad hoc group there itself. Though I do not know you, but I know that we all have similar liking and disliking. We all are from computer science background. We all are into the, you know, faculty fraternity, this teaching fraternity. So the chances of getting the similar query will be much higher. Ek na ek English mein ek proverb hai that says, बर्ड्स ऑफ सिमिलर फेदर फ्लॉक्स टूगेदर. जो लोगों की लाइकिंग डिसलाइकिंग एक जैसी होती है वो एक साथ उठते बैठते हैं. ठीक है, तो इफ तो अब सपोज आई एम अटेंडिंग दिस कॉन्फ्रेंस विद यू गाइज एंड आई वॉन्ट टू डाउनलोड द कॉन्फ्रेंस प्रोसीडिंग, वॉट आई वुड डू, आई विल ट्राई टू चेक फ्रॉम योर मोबाइल डिवाइसेज वेदर यू हैव डाउनलोडेड इट. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ सेंडिंग दैट क्वेरी टू द लोकेशन बेस्ड सर्वर, आई विल try to circulate that query among us, right? Among us. And chances of getting that query, that result in your mobile caches will be much higher. And if you know my location, then also it's not problem because you are also there. Aap bhi to wahi ho na? So if you know my location, I am here, that is anyways not going to affect me. But if location void server would know that I am here, it might create the trouble. So if I get the proceeding here, then I will stop the communication. If not, then one of the user acts as an agent and location-based server is contacted. If location-based server is contacted, then I will download my conference proceeding into my mobile. And next time, if you want or anybody who is sitting in the room, suppose we are sitting 100 people, anybody of them, you want that proceeding, that will be available from my mobile device. So less number of time the location-based server is being contacted. That's why we claim that we are enhancing the privacy. So coming to this slide now, caching with trust means हमने नाम CA पहले का उठा लिया caching का trust का ST उठा लिया and we call it a rhymic word cast. It was just you know occurred to me it was caching with trust. So for example जो लोग जिम में जिम जाते हैं those who are very much you know health freaks and fitness freak the chances of sending the similar queries much higher. Those who are working in the gym have very much highly likely to send the query like where is the nearest protein shop, where is the nearest gym equipment shop. The chances of this is much higher. The people who are working in the gym instead of those who are outside and eating something on samosa stall, right? तो जहाँ पे हम काम करते हैं उनके साथ जैसे for example हम सब एक office में काम करते हैं. I am just trying to bring your focus on the fourth image. There is a image of the office. Suppose I want to go out. We are working in the office and I want to know where is the nearest cinema, right? Nearest movie theater. So chances are very much likely that you must have my colleagues, one of my colleagues must have sent such type of query. So why to contact location based server? Why do not ask from my colleague's mobile devices itself? Every colleague we do not talk. We cannot go to everybody colleague and ask the same thing. We cannot do that, right? But our mobile can do that with the closed group network and accessing each other's caches. So this is the beauty of this approach, caching with trust. Those who have difficulty in understanding, please write in the chat box and I will repeat that. I am trying to be as plausible and clear as possible. So cast mein kya ho raha hai, we are having a P2P communication. Here we have one user that is able to access first this, but first this will make the group. How it can make the group? Unless and until I trust you. For that, first we evaluate the trust. How the trust evaluation will take place, I will let you know in the subsequent slides. So first trust is made. Once the trust value is higher than that is required, then each other's cache can be accessed. If data is found in the cache, then we call it a hit. Otherwise, it's a miss. If it is collaborative miss, that means data is not present in any of the mobile user in the group, then location-based server will be contacted, the last resort. So that is the main objective of this model. एक और एग्जाम्पल देना चाहूंगी मैं. सपोज मैं सूरत से बॉम्बे जाती हूँ. सूरत से बॉम्बे इज अ बिग हाईवे. हाँ, देन बट आई डू नॉट नो मच अबाउट द रूट असिस्टेंस. सो वॉट आर द चांसेस दैट दोज हु हमने वहां पे मिडवेज होते हैं. वी स्टॉप आर कार, वी टेक सम टॉयलेट ब्रेक, वी स्टॉप देयर, वी टेक सम हाई टी ब्रेक. When we are there, then there are very much high chances that those people who are into going into the same direction is sitting in that midway. बहुत ज़्यादा chances है ना कि मैं भी जा रही हूँ और भी कोई गाड़ियाँ जा रही हैं, तो they are going to the same destination or the destination that we have some common routes. Then chances of getting the further route assistance will definitely be there in their mobile caches because we are sharing some common thing, that is the highway where we are traveling. So how to identify the trust? How can I trust the other guy ki jiske main aise cash se data le rahi hu, he is not having any malicious intention? In order to find that, we identified one of the it is very much possible. Okay, I will come back. A very brilliant question is being asked. Let's keep his name anonymous as we are working on, the anonymous. We are keeping the user identity anonymous. Yeah, I will come back to this question. Yes, I know this, sir. I will come back to this question. Very wonderful observation, and I will come back to this. Okay, so how we trust it? The trust is fulfillment count is the parameter. हमने तीन चार parameter identify करे जिससे ये पता चल जाएगा कि trust क्या है उस person का, who is the part of that group. Fulfillment count is suppose P Q E. ये क्या चीज है? P है जो data जिसको चाहिए, Q है जो mobile cache उसको data provide करा रहा है, E क्या है? Communication number. कम्युनिकेशन एक्सचेंजेस, तो हमने नाम दे दिया इसको ई. अगर मुझे कोई डेटा चाहिए और मुझे सपोज फॉर एग्जाम्पल मनीष सर का जो मोबाइल है, बिकॉज ही इज ओनली एक्टिव, आई कुड एबल टू रिकॉल हिज नेम मोर ऑफन, तो अगर उनके मोबाइल से मुझे डेटा मिल जाता है तो आई एम पी, ही इज क्यू, राइट? और एक कम्युनिकेशन एक्सचेंज है, सपोज मैं फर्स्ट टाइम उनसे डेटा ले रही हूँ तो कम्युनिकेशन एक्सचेंज विल बी वन. So if that data, what I have received from Manish sir's mobile is relevant to me, fully relevant, then I will give him one. I will give his mobile one. My fulfillment count and how satisfied I am getting the result, that means one. If it is partial relevant to me, मैंने उनसे proceeding मांगी, आधी मेरे पास पहुंची, आधी इनके पास थी नहीं due to some reason. Suppose proceeding is of 50 pages and I could able to get only 20, 30 is gone because of some reason, or maybe his cache could not able to store all the 50 pages, I could able to get 20 pages, then answer to this query was given to me, but that was partially relevant to me, not fully relevant. So I will give him 1/2. And if I am seeing something and I am not able to receive anything, if it is not relevant at all, suppose मैंने proceeding मांगी थी आपसे NRI institute and that proceeding what I received is from some JRD institute, for example, it is not relevant to me at all. So that will be given to zero. In this way, fulfillment count is given from P user to Q user. Another is communication and exchange count. Communication exchange count is suppose ECP. P means me, मैं user P. मैंने अभी तक कितने communication में participate करा है? PI. Till ith communication, the summation of all, suppose I have participated in 50 communication. So my ECP would be 50. Out of them, मैंने 50 में से 20 में communication में result दिया है, तो my performance will be 20 on 50. That is, out of 50 communication, or in 20, the data was present in my mobile device. So how many communication exchange I was in the part of, it is known as exchange count. कितने time exchange data हुआ है. Finally, raised flag count. Raised flag count ऐसे लोगों के लिए which are malicious in nature. It is possible कि Manish sir का data is, Manish sir का mobile is providing me the right result. But because I am malicious in nature, instead of one, I am giving him zero. Data बिल्कुल relevant था, लेकिन मैं नहीं चाहती उनकी credibility बढ़े. मैंने उनको zero दे दिया. देना चाहिए था मुझे one, क्योंकि मैं सारा data उनका utilize किया. क्योंकि वो इन्फॉर्मेशन वॉज फुल्ली रेलिवेंट टू मी, बट इंस्टेड ऑफ माई मैलिशियस इंटेंशन आई गेव द क्यू जीरो. सो आई एम द मलिशियस वन. दैट सच काइंड ऑफ हाउ टू नो दैट हु आर मलिशियस एंड हु आर नॉट, उसके लिए हमने यूज करा रेज्ड फ्लैग काउंट. इफ एनीबडी सीज, every mobile device carry a mini database, and if anybody sees a malicious activity, then if anybody see that I am malicious, I am using the data and I am giving zero instead of one, then that person can raise a flag in his database against me. Mere naam ke aage wo one kar dega ki that person is having ill intention. Another person is also observing, unke beta database mein wo mere against, P ke against kar dega one, flag one. जैसे जैसे फ्लैग रेज करेगा मेरी क्रेडिबिलिटी कम होती जाएगी, एंड व्हेन वी हैव क्यूमुलेटिव डेटाबेस असेसमेंट, इफ अगेंस्ट माय क्रेडिबिलिटी डेटाबेस सेज दैट यू आर हैविंग 4 रेज फ्लैग काउंट, 5 रेज फ्लैग काउंट, देन इन फॉर फ्यूचर फॉर डेल्टा टी टाइम आई विल नॉट बी द पार्ट ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन ग्रुप. सो दैट इज द वे वी कैन एबल टू फिल्टर आउट द जेन्युइन ट्रस्टवर्दी पीपल देन फेक वंस. Using these values, we have come up with a fundamental trust equation. We have come up with a fundamental, हमने क्या क्या use करा, fulfillment count, exchange count, and raise flag count, and we have come up with a fundamental trust equation. Fulfillment count upon exchange count. कितने exchange में हमने part लिया और कितने exchange में जो part था वो fulfillment value receive हुई upon 1 upon RFC because it is reversely proportional to each other. तो अगर raised flag count बढ़ेगा तो आपका trust parameter कम होगा. अगर raised flag count कम होगा तो trust would be higher. It is simple mathematical construct. This was all about trusting. Now comes caching model. Caching model वही caching model है जो हमने main memory और processor में communication बढ़ाने के लिए किया है. Communication is free, computation time. It is having the same conventional meaning. Hit local means when I need some replies from location-based server, but data what I need is already present in my mobile device cache. It is known as hit local. If data is not present in my device, we call it miss local. Upon miss local, the group is formed. Group is formed and then each mobile devices of that group is searched. If data is present in any of the caches, that is collaborative, it is known as hit collaborative. That means data is present somewhere in the group. If data is neither present in the mobile device of mine nor in any of the mobile device of the group members, then we call it miss collaborative. Data kahin bhi present nahi hai, that is needed. In that case, location-based server is contacted. Location-based server is contacted in a distributive way where one of the mobile user as agent and my communication will carry out through that. Once the result from the location-based server has come, then there are very much high chances next time the server will not be contacted at all if any of the group member wants to download or wants to have the similar data or information. This whole story, what I have told, I have tried to, come up with the phases. First is discovering neighbor phase. And this whole story, what we are talking. Discovering neighbor phase says, mere ko data chahiye, I want you people to help me. And I want to be K anonymous. Discovering mein kitne users ko discover karna chahti hu, K minus one. I want to check caches of 5 people. One is me. 4 would be more. So 4 people group I form. I will check trust. Phase 2 is trust evaluation. If their trust using that trust equation is more than that is required, then we call it trust evaluation phase would say your trust is okay. Aisa possible hai ki kisi ka trust value is lesser than what is needed. In that case, we again go to the discovering neighbor phase. Again, we call more neighbors. And we restart the trust evaluation. Trust evaluation phase ends only when all of the members that are the part of the group have a minimum level of expected trust. Once it is done, then cache collaboration. Cache collaboration means, ab hum ek dusre ki cache ko dekhenge, right? I want to check because mujhe data chahiye. I will go through your caches. And that is done by random. It is not like those who have come quick in the group, their caches will be accessed more. No. So it is on the random basis. And this collaboration phase will take place till the time is there a hit. Jaise first hit hoga, it will stop. Or it will take time till exhaustively all the caches are checked and data is not found anywhere. In that case, miss collaborative event occurs and server is contacted. So whenever you try to portray your proposed work, try to come up with some sequencing so that whenever a reader read your paper, it becomes very easy for him to understand. So these are the experimental results. We can say we can see well different k items. हमने इसको टेस्ट करा k is equal to 5 के लिए, k is equal to 10 के लिए, k is equal to 15 के लिए, and for k is equal to 20. And we compared with no CC means no cash collaboration. कोई cash collaboration था ही नहीं, right? That means only we are contacting directly to the location based server. So here you can say the next says next what do you call it? Next graph says the bar graph says data retrieval from server percentage. ठीक है, पहला ग्राफ बता रहा है कि कितना टाइम लगा उनको एक्सेस करने में. थर्ड बता रहे कि हाउ मेनी टाइम्स सर्वर इज कॉन्टेक्टेड वेन के वॉज फाइव. सी दिस इज फॉर डिफरेंट कैश साइजेस. हमने कंसिडर करा कैश साइज इज हैविंग 20 डेटा आइटम्स, 50 डेटा आइटम्स, 100 डेटा आइटम्स, 150, ऑल द कैशेस दैट प्रेजेंट. एंड अगर एक हर एक कैश में 20 डेटा आइटम्स होंगे और सपोज कैशेज की वैल्यू है 5 नंबर ऑफ यूजर्स, दैट मीन्स 5 2 10, 100 डेटा आइटम्स आर अवेलेबल. ये डेटा आइटम्स डिस्टिंक्ट भी हो सकते हैं, नॉन डिस्टिंक्ट भी हो सकते हैं, मतलब सेम भी हो सकते हैं, डिसिमिलर भी हो सकते हैं. तो वी हैव आइडेंटिफाइड, ट्राई टू एक्सपेरिमेंटेड विद नॉन डिस्टिंक्ट एंड डिस्टिंक्ट, बोथ आइटम्स. हियर आई हैव प्रेजेंटेड ओनली वन ग्राफ, बट आई हैव ओनली वन अदर ग्राफ वेयर द डेटा आइटम्स आर डिस्टिंक्ट. दैट मीन्स सारे डेटा आइटम अलग हैं, 100 के 100 अलग हैं. नॉन डिस्टिंक्ट मीन्स देयर कैन बी सम रेप्लिकेशन एज वेल. So when k was 5, then we can see 70% of the time the server was contacted. 70% is only the data could able to find in the group or at local device 30% of time. As we move forward in the first level of this graph, you can see it is k is equal to 10. 10 may almost 60% of time the location based server is contacted, and only 40% of the time data was available in the either in the group or in the mobile device. As we grow, as we move from left to right to this graph, you would see for cache size is 20 and for k is equal to 20, yani ki 20 people with 20, right? So it is like almost 1400 data items that only 30% of the time the location based server is contacted, while 70% the data is found in the group itself. As we move further in this, as we read this graph more, we can find if the cache size is increased and K is also increased as big as 20, then you can see only 5% time, right? Only 5, or I guess 5 more, okay, more than, less than 5 times the server is contacted. Rest over 95% time the data could able to find in the group itself or in the mobile cache itself. So we need to find an adequate balance between the cache size and the number of K used for K anonymity. Okay? Then we can say this approach is helpful to find the values. Now come these experimental results for different cache size was 20. Then you can see ye gray wala dikha raha hai hit collaborative, and this blank shows hit local. So for k is equal to 20, total 71% time that data was available through cast. And this cast, 10% time it is hit local and 61% time is hit collaborative. I will go move forward to the cache size 150, and you can see remarkable achievement here. For k is equal to 20, 97% time out of 100, 97 requests could able to cater the result within the group itself, right? Out of them, 45 times the data was present in the mobile device and 52% time the data was present in the group somewhere. So see how less number of time location-based server is contacted and our location is exposed outside the group. With this, I would like to also tell one thing. What we have tried to cover this through this, many of our faculty members, what I have observed in my 13-14 years of my teaching, we have a fear of mathematical expression, right? Many of us in the research are falling short to write a mathematical model of our proposed work, right? I don't know how many of you are agree to it. How many you think that mathematical modeling is difficult to do? I know it is going to be the lunchtime. Okay. Yeah, very nice. Yeah, it's logical, not difficult, but many of the people think that it is difficult to do. Everything has a logic, but people, have you ever observed that why mathematics is needed? Why do we need this language? Why we cannot describe it into English or in the text? Why there is a need of mathematics only? Because mathematics is the only language. Mathematics is also the language of expression. Mathematics is the only language that do not have any ambiguity. If I write certain equation with the conditions, then that equation and statement will only mean to a single meaning. It will not intend to any other meaning. So that's why in English, whenever English you write any statement, different people will interpret it differently, because we have in English, we have oxymorons, we have homophones, we have lot many things in the English expression, where it is possible that one statement, one sentence leads to more than one meaning. However, in mathematics is the only language that is considered to be most apt for research, because a statement or a sentence in mathematics will never lead to more than one interpretation. It will always hold a single meaning. That's why it makes your proposed work more, fills with more clarity, and it gives the right interpretation what you want to say. So for those who are working into this, I would like to appeal to them to just come up with a small mathematical modeling, try to use already existing papers, try to find out the way that how can you fix your values into it and come up with your mathematical modeling. So, one question I had with the sir that how can we, and very brilliant observation, we send our kids to school, how can we monitor them, how can we watch them? I tell you, I was there in Surat for a few years, and there was a little expensive school. They used to have one sensor in their bus, in their bus, and it was a fleet management kind of system, where wherever the bus travels, it sends the, wherever the bus travels, it sends the coordinate or the information to their parents' mobile. For that, we use the such kind of RFID tags, because of the their expensive nature, they could not get materialized. It involves a huge infrastructure, but many of the offices use RFID tags to locate their staff members. But for these days, we are having a device that comes as, it looks like a badge, simple badge. It is a simple sensor that actually sends your location coordinate and gets mapped and linked with your mobile device. So I will tell you the exact name and the company of that device, where you give it, keep it, like we keep a badge on our kid. We keep that badge on their blazer, and whenever they go to their schools, we can monitor them because we can have the live tracking through our mobile devices. So it is very easy to track them. So all of you are invited for asking the questions. And right now I am working in the hardware security aspect of privacy and security. And those who are willing to work as an faculty interns, or those who are actually want to contribute in the research community, I would like to extend this opportunity to all of you. If you want to, I just forgot to put my email ID here. Please write back to me. Let me write the email ID here so that. It is not working.
Ma'am, I have, may I share your email ID?
Yes, sir. Please, sir, I am unable to write. I don't know, Zoom. It is not going into the edit mode. Yeah. So please, sir, you float their email ID in the chat. Achha, chat box bhi toh hai na. We can send in the chat box itself. Huh? This is my email ID. Oh my God, I have not sent it to everyone. Let me send it to everyone again. This is my email ID to everyone. Those who feel like working in this area, those who really want to, contribute. So please contact me, see if I can help you out. So that's all from my side. Can you please, everybody, if anybody you have any questions, please come forward and ask.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Dr. Ruchika Gupta, for a wonderful session, wonderful lecture. And now I would like to request to all of my dear participants who are very patiently watching this lecture. If you have any query or questions related to today's lecture, as Dr. Ruchika Gupta ma'am told that about the location-based services, if you any query or any question related to all, please you may ask. We have 10 minutes more. So if you have any query or questions, please you may ask. Dear participants, have you any query? You may also write on chat box to me or direct to Dr. Ruchika Gupta ma'am. If you have any query, you may also write on a chat box. Okay, I think all of my participants in this FDP have cleared their views. So now I would like to request Professor Anamika Singh to say a word of thanks to Dr. Ruchika Gupta ma'am.
Good afternoon, everyone. Hi, I, Anamika Singh, Assistant Professor, Department of CSE. Would like to thank our guest speaker, Dr. Ruchita Gupta ma'am. Today's lecture was full of knowledge and interesting things. It gave deep insights into the topic and also revealed some interesting facts. I am pretty sure the precious knowledge that Dr. Ruchita Gupta ma'am gave us will definitely help us in our studies and future. Once again, I would like to thank Dr. Ruchita Gupta ma'am for taking our time from their busy schedule and enlightening us with the knowledge. Thank you so much, ma'am. I would like to thank Professor एससी चौबे सर टेक्यूब कोऑर्डिनेटर आरजीपीबी भोपाल प्रिंसिपल फॉर गिविंग परमिशन टू ऑर्गेनाइज द एफडीपी. आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक सर डॉक्टर पूरन गौर सर प्रिंसिपल एनआईआरटी एंड कन्वीनियर ऑफ दिस इवेंट हु सपोर्ट कंटिन्यूसली ड्यूरिंग द एफडीपी. I also want to thank the coordinator, Professor Manish Kumar Singhal sir, and organizing committee who really worked hard to make this session successful. Also, thank you to all the participants present here for paying your attention and learning. Thank you so much. This is Professor Anamika Singh signing off. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Anamika. Thank you very much. And,
Manish, can I do one correct? Can I do one submission? Can I say something?
Please, ma'am. Please.
Okay. And Anamika, ma'am, you have done a wonderful job. But my small submission is either say Dr. Ruchika Gupta or Ruchika, ma'am. Dr. Ruchika Gupta, ma'am. Dr. Manish Kumar Singhal, sir. It is not making any sense. This is must just small contribution. At times we get so humble that we in praising, so either say Dr. Ruchika Gupta or Ruchika ma'am. It will help you in next time when you give vote of thanks. It was small something. Please don't take it offensively. That is how I learned in my life.
Okay.
Thank you, Ruchika ma'am. Thank you so much for giving a wonderful session. We are highly obliged from NGI family. And I also thanks to Dr. Puran Gorsar, Principal NIRT, Dr. David Kumarji Vajpayee, senior professor, and my whole team of this FPP, and obviously thanks to all your participants for listening the wonderful session very efficiently. And once again, last but not least, Dr. Ruchika Gupta for giving her very eminent lecture for this event. Thank you, Dr. Ruchika.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Yeah, it's nice to be here. Thank you.
Thank you. Dear participants, this is over FDP for today. We have another eminent speaker for tomorrow sessions, Dr. Irshad Ahmad Ansari from IIITDM, Jabalpur. So we are expecting that you are coming at the same time. Tomorrow, 11:45 to 2 p.m. Thank you. This is Professor Manish Kumar Singhal, HOD CSE, coordinator of this event, signing off today. Thank you so much.